Welcome to Campus Insiders Oregon. I'm Jill Savage. To help us break down the Oregon-Texas Alamo Bowl is our Texas Insider, Ted Emmerich. Ted, now we all know this is going to be Mack Brown's last game as head coach of Texas, but let's get into the X's and O's. It looks like Texas has a really good run game. That's where Oregon's defense struggles. Now, we broke down the running back duo of Brown and then Jonathan Gray. Brown has over 700 yards, 9 touchdowns. Jonathan Gray earlier in the year tore his Achilles, but also had over 700 yards and 4 touchdowns.
Yeah, Jill, with Gray out, he was having a breakout season. No question, here as a sophomore, but he is the most dynamic running back on the Texas roster. Without Gray, the duo becomes Malcolm Brown and Joe Bergeron, and both of them are bruisers. Brown, 225 pounds. Bergeron is 230. Texas likes to hammer away with both, like they did against Texas Tech when both went over 100 yards. Both have had to overcome something in their careers. For Brown, it was injuries, a toe as a freshman, an ankle as a sophomore. Now he's healthy, and he's excited about this Alamo Bowl, again, because his hometown is San Antonio. For Bergeron, he had to overcome fumbles. He had lost the trust of the coaching staff. 16 touchdowns last year, but he just couldn't hang on to the football this year. Became the third team back. He didn't pout. He went to special teams, did his work there, and now he's taken advantage of a new opportunity with Gray going down.
Looking at Case McCoy, he has 11 touchdowns to 11 interceptions. Is he that average? And was it him? Was it his offensive line, his receivers? What was the cause for all those interceptions?
Yeah, it's Case McCoy, and he'll tell you that. He had the worst game of his life against Baylor. Against Oklahoma State, 3 interceptions. He took the blame. First thing he said in the postgame press conference, "This is on me." But at the very least, Case McCoy is a good sport about it. Earlier in the season against TCU, Texas was listed as the underdog going in. And Texas coming off a win over Oklahoma, and you thought, oh, that's kind of curious. Why is TCU the favorite? And Case said, well, it's probably because I'm the quarterback. McCoy knows he has to have the game of his life. He has to play under control if Texas is going to have a chance to beat Oregon.
You mentioned before that Texas is vulnerable against mobile quarterbacks. Oregon, of course, coming in with Marcus Mariota, they like to run the ball more. So is this going to be a problem for Texas, who gives up 180 yards rushing every game? Is this really playing into Oregon's hand?
Now, Oregon better be licking its chops, looking at Texas. The problem for the Longhorns right now, they're weak up the middle because of injuries. Their star senior defensive tackle, Chris Whaley, out for the year. 2 linebackers out for the season as well, Jordan Hicks and Steve Edmund. It's not just Taysom Hill early in the season for BYU. We can all refer back to that game, the 500 yards rushing. Look late in the season. Oklahoma State's Clint Chelf, not known as a mobile quarterback, he couldn't be stopped on a simple draw play. Baylor with 2 running backs, Glasgow Martin and Lake Seastrunk, they did whatever they wanted against Texas. So Oregon now with Mariota and Marshall and Tyner and Thomas and all their stable of backs, yes, they have a decided advantage against Texas there.
Well, give me your general prediction then for the game. How do you think this plays out?
Yeah, you know, Mack's last game, there's going to be a lot of burnt orange in San Antonio. Jill, I could see this being close for a half, maybe 3 quarters. But let's face it, Oregon is the best team that Texas has played in a bowl game since Alabama in the national championship 4 years ago. Maybe Texas uses a trick play, pulls that out of the bag, and keeps it close for a while. But Oregon is just too good on paper. Maybe they're disinterested in the Alamo Bowl, but they'll turn it on late. They'll pull away in the 4th quarter and win by 2 scores.
Ted Emmerich, our Texas insider, making friends here in the state of Oregon. Thanks so much, Ted. We'll talk to you soon.
Jill, thanks so much.
Oregon and Texas kick off the Alamo Bowl Monday, December 30th at 3:45 Pacific time.